an offense before God, then I will take his side and let him reveal. Then take the side of man and risk separating myself. And so you can tell me that your sin is small, and I'm going to say it still costs Jesus his life. You can say, well, I'm only going to do it for a little while. Well, you don't have that say-so. Because once Satan gets in charge, he's got right away. You can't tell the devil, well, just let me off at the corner. No. His goal, if you didn't know it, in John 10:10 says, the enemy comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. And Pastor Barbara said, you know, sometimes we try to live so close to the edge. Well, the problem with being close to the edge is that Satan can reach you. And he starts stealing things. And you know, Satan is kind of cool. You know, he comes in and you don't really notice him taking things at first. Some things start disappearing. And it's the non-essentials. Oh, I didn't read my Bible today. Oh, it's not that big of a deal. So he takes that. And, you know, it doesn't seem like that big of a deal. Satan comes into your life, he's looking around. He takes your Sunday morning worship. You don't notice it so much because you still hang out with Christians, so you think, oh, okay. One by one, Satan starts stealing things from you. But I want you to know, he's after you. He's not after the things. And sometimes a lot of things start missing in our life as a believer. And we don't even realize. Oh, I can't find my Christian music. Well, I'll just listen to this worldly song today. It won't mean much. He just stole your worship. Well, I'm just going to kick back tonight. It's Wednesday night. I'm just going to kick back and watch a little TV. He just stole your word for the day. And so, little by little, he's taking things away. Because you were living so close to the edge. You just wanted to do the least little thing. You just wanted to commit what you had to. And before long, you realize your heart's empty. You have no desire for God anymore. You have no desire for his word because Satan snatched it away. You have no desire for worship because Satan snatched it away. You have no desire for Christian music because the devil gave you a replacement. You have no desire for the friends of church because you haven't seen them in so long, so I'll just go hang with the neighbors. And see, all the while he was stealing. But it's going to progress. And then he's going to kill. And then he's going to destroy. And so those little things that started disappearing in your life, you didn't recognize them because they left one by one. But they pile up. And before long, you realize you're empty. You've been cleaned out by the devil. He has stolen everything. And you are empty, so you've lost your confidence. There was confidence when I first came to Christ. And I want you to go to the next slide. I think that's the scripture. Hebrews 3:12-14. This kind of paints that picture in a sense. Let's see if we can get it. See to it, brothers, that none of you has a sinful, unbelieving heart that turns away from the living God. But encourage one another daily as long as it's called today, so that none of you may be hardened by sin's deceitfulness. We have come to share Christ if we hold firmly till the end the confidence we had at first. That I'm coming to Christ, I'm staying with Christ. Devil, you come in and you try to take my Bible, I will take it out of your hands, I will read it. If the enemy says, don't you read that, you ain't got to read that, I'm going to read it all the more.
Amen.
If the devil comes in and he says, well, I can't find my Christian music, well, I'm just going to start praising the Lord until I do. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. I'll make up the song if I have to. You say no. You meet him at the door of your life and you say, not on my life. Nothing between my Lord and my Savior. Yeah. Nothing between my soul and my Savior.
Yeah.
You're not getting it here, devil.
Yeah.
You're not getting my word for today. You're not taking it away. I will be at Wednesday night service.
Yeah.
I will be at Sunday morning. I will be at discipleship. I'll show up with a journal. I'll write down what I need to write down. You're not getting me, devil. Yeah. You're not getting me. You're not going to take my prayer away. I'm going to pray all the more.
Yeah.
I'm going to fight. Because see, when you come to Christ, when we come to Christ and he forgives you, and I want to tell you, he frees you. When you ask Jesus in your heart, he will set you free. And when he sets you free, a confidence will consume you that you know you've been forgiven. You feel light as air and you want to jump around. And you want to tell others, Jesus has rescued me. I'm not the same. My heart has changed. And it says, we've come to share in Christ if we hold firmly to the end the confidence we have at first.
Amen.
But you know what Satan does? He comes in and he takes your confidence. Because little by little, he gets you to compromise with this and compromise that and change your attitude about sin. That sin was horrible when you were at the altar confessing it. But as you got away from the believers, as you got away from the church, all of a sudden you're like, well, it wasn't that bad. And man, I don't feel that pressure anymore, you know. I'm just gonna go ahead and play around a little bit. The problem is there's many people that do that and never come back. Because all he needs is an inch. He doesn't need much to destroy. And God does not owe you two times. He owes you once. He said he has made a way for all to come. He wishes that none should perish. But he doesn't owe you chance after chance. That's us presuming upon his grace. His grace has appeared for all of us. And it teaches us to say no to ungodliness and worldly passions. And we can't say, I want all this worldly stuff and say, I am so with Christ. Because you're so not. You're so not. The world is between you and him. If you want the stuff of the world, then that's between you and God. It's snuck in. And it sneaks in like this. But then, he comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But if we hold firmly with confidence, and that's why it says, see to it, brothers, that none of you have a sinful, unbelieving heart that turns away from the living God. But encourage one another daily. Daily, we got to be talking to each other. Daily, we got to be saying, sin can get in. Sin can get in. Nip it in the bud. Don't play with it. Don't let it in. Get it out. Warn your brother. Warn your sister. Ask them to warn you. Check yourself daily. Is there anything between me and God? Is there anything between me and God? Keep a short checklist between you and God. Because see, little by little, the devil will take it away. That's why you got to keep short account. I know what I've got in Jesus Christ. And every morning, I'm going to double check and make sure I still got it. Is he still my Savior? Do I still hate sin? Am I still saying no to the devil? Am I going to trust his word? I'm not asking you if it feels good. I'm not asking you if you want to read the word. I'm saying you got to do it. See to it. See to it that none of you has a sinful, unbelieving heart. And encourage one another as long as it's as it's called today, so that none of you may be hardened by sin's deceitfulness. Satan sneaks in. Paul says, flee the evil desires of your youth. They're going to come. They came to all of us. Every one of us has been tempted in the same ways. And we got to say, run! If we know Jesus. And if we don't know Jesus, we're going to be going out snatching others. And it says, hating even the garments that are stained with sin. I'm going to run after you to the drug house and say, get out of there! Get out of there! Jesus don't want you there! But I'm not sticking around. I'm not going to stick around and linger in it. I'm going to come for you. And if you don't want to go, sooner or later, I got to go. I got to get back over here. We got to keep it real, guys. And young people, you are the ones that are on the firing line. Because you're in schools where it is bombarded through the teaching. It's bombarded through the students. You see so much at your age that we didn't see at ours. And so Paul is saying, run. Run. Run from evil. Run from it. Don't stick around and laugh at it. It is not funny when someone disobeys the living God. It's not funny when someone disrespects authority. It's not funny when someone gets punched in the eye and everybody else is just trying to video it on their phone and get it on YouTube. That's not funny. That's sin. That sent Jesus to the cross. If we're laughing about it, we're on the wrong side. And that's what I'm talking about those evil desires that come in, because we get caught up in the moment. And you can't afford to get caught up in the moment. You got to keep your head. And you got to say, I got to flee. I've got to warn. And that is why we have teachers and pastors and disciples that are constantly warning us. They're constantly saying, get that out of your life. Get it out of your life. Don't play with that. Don't play with that. You know what? When we're young, we're immature, and we think we can get close to stuff, and it won't hurt us. A baby will go all the way to that stove a zillion times until finally it hits that fire. And I guarantee you, once that baby hits that fire, it ain't ever going back to that stove again because it got burned. How close are you willing to get with sin? Are you going to let Satan burn you? Are you going to let him destroy you? Because I want to tell you, you don't have control once you start inching towards it. And so you better run while you've got your head, while you can make a decision. Tonight, I want to tell you, if Satan has been causing you to compromise, making you think sin really wasn't that bad, I'm praying that this is a wake-up call tonight. Guys, when I heard this song the other day, I'm telling you, it was a wake-up call for me. I said, oh, God, I don't want anything between me. I don't want anything between me and my Savior. I've got to make it to heaven. I'm not going to gamble my soul. And I just want to ask you tonight, are you at a point in your life where you can say, I want to hate sin? And if you are ready to hate sin, and you want to exchange it for the love of God, you can tonight. If you're a young person and you feel like you've already been caught inching towards sin, I want to tell you, you've got a golden opportunity tonight in this morning. But you can look at me and laugh and wait for the knowledge to hit you in another way. But I can guarantee you that if you don't heed the warnings, you'll pay the ultimate price. It'll cost you everything. Have your fun, but it'll cost you everything in the end. And you will be begging God, God, why? Why did you stop me? He tried. He sent you teachers. He sent you disciples. He sent you parents. He sent you preachers. He sent little church ladies, whatever. But we still want to act like it's no big deal. Let's stand tonight.